Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Digital Signal Processing. So in our past videos, we are discussing about circular convolution. So in the different methodologies, concentric circle method as well as matrix multiplication method. So today, some of the maybe discrete Fourier transform, inverse discrete Fourier transform, that is DFT, IDFT method used when we solve for that. எப்படி சால்வ் பண்ணலாம்ங்கறத வந்து we are going to see in this video. So let us consider two sequences x of n 1 1 2 m 2 1 as well as h of n 1 2 3 4. So இப்போ இத வந்து சால்வ் பண்றதுக்கு we are taking discrete Fourier transform as well as we are using inverse discrete Fourier transform. So discrete Fourier transform, so எல்லாருமே familiar தான். X of k is equal to summation of n varies from 0 to infinity x of n e power minus j 2 by k n by n. So this is the formula of Fourier transform. So where k varies from 0 to, so actually it is n minus 1. N varies from 0 to n minus 1. K also varies from 0 to n minus 1. So this is the Fourier transform forward Fourier transform formula. So either on the we are applying for x1 of k as well as h1 of k. So why we are using DFT as well as IDFT means? So that is that one of the property of Fourier transform is convolution theorem. So convolution theorem வந்து நிறைய transforms ல வந்து யூஸ் பண்றோம். That is convolution in time domain is equal to multiplication in frequency domain. So time domain ல வந்து நம்ம அந்த convolution operation வந்து calculate பண்றது வந்து ஈஸியா வந்து frequency domain க்கு வந்து signal convert பண்ணிட்டீங்கனா just you can go for multiplication operation. So convolution னா வந்து with both multiplication also there, addition is also there. So அதை வந்து ஓவர் கம் பண்றதுக்காக the sequences வந்து நம்ம Fourier transform எடுத்துட்டோம்னா then you can multiply both the result. So அதுக்கு அப்புறமா once again inverse discrete Fourier transform apply பண்ணீங்கன்னா you will get your required output y of n. So இதான் வந்து procedure. For first x of n as well as h of n ரெண்டுமே வந்து we are going to apply the this one forward Fourier transform. So this is the formula of DFT. So here we are calculating for x1 of k. So in the formula solve panni simplify pannona you will get x1 of k. So after simplification you will get 5 minus 1 1 minus 1. So Fourier transform time conception adhigam avangaladala just I skip that. So our answer is after simplifying this equation and substituting all these things, you will get 5 minus 1, 1 minus 1. Similarly, the h of n, so the h of k, other than the calculate formula, what we will get means 10 minus 2 plus j2 minus 2 minus 2 minus j2. So h of k, x of k, ரெண்டுமே வந்து நம்ம கால்குலேட் பண்ணிட்டோம். இப்போ வந்து so as per our convolution theorem, convolution in time domain is equal to multiplication in frequency domain. So for finding y of k, just multiply these two sequences. 5 into 10, you will get 50. Next, minus 1, here second sequence is this one. So you will get 2 minus j2. Then this one multiplied by minus 2, you will get minus 2. Then minus 1 multiplied by this one. So 2 plus j2. So this is the output in the frequency domain y of k. So if on the number original signals on the LRE on the time domain like the x of n as well as h of n. So we will the required output y of n. So therefore, here you apply the inverse discrete Fourier transform. So therefore, write the formula for inverse discrete Fourier transform. So just remember small change for now. So your IDFT formula is x of n is equal to 1 by n. So in this case, the n value is 4, and here k varies from 0 to n minus 1, and here you are having x of k. So in this case, it is y of k, the values of the substitute monopolon, e power j 2 by an by n, and here n varies from 0 to n minus 1. So this is a formula for inverse discrete Fourier transform. 1 by n multiplied by the summation of x of k e power j 2 by kn divided by n, where limits varies from 0 to n minus 1 and n varies from 0 to n minus 1. So if I the y of k on the substitute for me, simplify for one, you will get y of n. So our y of n becomes 13, 14, 11, 12. So after taking inverse discrete Fourier transform, you get the answer 13, 14, 11, 12. So in this manner, without doing concentric circle method or matrix multiplication method, so rendume illama, with the help of forward discrete Fourier transform as well as inverse discrete Fourier transform also, you can solve circular convolution. So procedure of the first given sequences, we are going to apply the forward discrete Fourier transform and find out the answers. Then you multiply both the answers, because convolution in time domain is equal to multiplication in the frequency domain. So to get y of k, you are multiplying x of k as well as h of k. Then you need y of n. Y of n method, just you are applying the inverse discrete Fourier transform to the y of k. So afterwards, you are getting the answer like this. So thank you. Thanks for watching. So the video will be like pannunga, share pannunga, and subscribe pannunga. So if you have feedbacks, comment section. So feedbacks. Thank you once again.